current member of the Electric Truck Conversion Project. The team member consists of myself, Kevin Lazima, Giovanni Carmona, and Arjun Kohli, as well as our team mentor, Ron Grossinger. The purpose of this project is to showcase the effectiveness and the potential of the electric vehicle and hopefully inspire others, such as larger companies, to take on the electric vehicle movement. As many of you may know, this project has actually been ongoing for 2 years now, and so far the current and past team members have gutted the entire engine bay, leaving only some spare parts. They've also mocked up the circuits needed to run the motor, and that's shown in a table, a plywood table, and all the components are basically screwed in. In this spring semester, we actually relocated to SA119. It's a bigger facility and it's indoors. So, recently we actually created a coupler to connect the engine to the transmission, which then drives the wheels. In this assembly, we actually put it onto the engine bay itself just to see how everything fits. And this is our mentor posing in front of the truck. And this is the actual assembly, minus the electrical components, which will be added on later. This is the actual motor, the transmission, and inside of that is the coupler, which makes the two pieces. And here is an up-close photo of this. This is the coupler, which is mounted to the torque converter of the transmission. And this side is for the engine, and it has a key slot, which fits into it. However, with this coupler that we made, there's a lot of faults in it, in its design. It's inherently weak because of this right angle here between the step, and that causes a stress riser. So when we go up in a higher torque, that could potentially snap, and we'd lose control of the vehicle. Furthermore, the holes that could bolt up to our torque converter are actually not in line, so we'd have to remeasure and redesign. This misalignment is actually causing the engine to shake vigorously. So if you go up in higher RPMs, it'll potentially cause a lot of damage to the engine and transmission. So we really need to fix that part. And our current design challenge for that, it's a coupler. The coupler that we use causes the motor and transmission to shake vigorously. And there's also weak spots. And yeah, tolerances are not the best. The criteria for the new coupler that we're in the process of making, it has to be able to withstand a lot of torque, since the electric motor actually outputs probably more torque than the combustion engine that was in it. It needs to fit, clearance is better. The current one that we have isn't that good, it's just a rough design. And we need to eliminate the wobble present in the current design. All tests with the new designs are gonna be tested like outside of the vehicle, so we don't have to keep on placing new prototypes onto the motor and then try to run it like that. Essentially, it's an apparatus where you could test the torque by pretty much going on a lever and then turning it. If you guys want, you could submit your own designs, and then we could have a challenge, possibly like a prize, to see whose design is the best. Once this coupler is finally finished and machined, we can move on to fabricating a new motor mount. The motor mount, as seen here in the orange, is only temporary. It's made out of just flat iron, and it's not as sturdy as we would want it to. Furthermore, these bolts here do not actually line up with our, it's hard to show, but over here, the receiving end of that motor mount, and they don't line up, so you have to fix that. So afterwards, we could start fitting all the electrical components onto the engine bay in a systematic way to where we could reach all the components safely and without shocking ourselves. That also includes installing the pedal, switches, and battery packs. The battery packs will actually be mounted at the truck bed, and we'll have two troughs, I guess, that the batteries could fit into. Finally, we could test the truck after that. Usually, like, we're pretty much done at that point. However, we want to do a shakedown test, see if anything is broken before we can take it out to the road. These are just contact information if you're interested in joining, or if you have questions, concerns, or any input, please feel free to email theelectrictruckproject@gmail.com, as well as the team mentor at ron.grossinger@gmail.com, as well as mine at rpjtillington. We'll also update weekly on what the progress is for what we're doing.